And buddy, let me get some opinions on you. Saturday, Danny Garcia, Brandon Rios. Good fight. Didn't end too well for Brandon. Danny got the victory. What did you think about the fight, and what did you think about Danny's performance?
It was predictable. I mean, anybody who knows boxing knows that Garcia is going to beat him. Mm-hmm. It's just a matter of time, when, and I mean, what round. Mm.
So were you impressed with anything Danny was able to do in there?
I'm going to be honest with you. After like four or five rounds, I turned it off. Because you can see he was just setting him up, getting some rounds in under his belt, which, you know, it's a good thing. And then I turned back to the Devin Alexander fight, and then I seen he got robbed. I mean, they called the fight a draw, which to me was kind of disgusting in boxing. You know, that was a terrible decision. I love Victor Ortiz. I got a lot of respect for him. You know what I mean? But, I mean, to me, I thought Devin won clearly.
And as far as Danny's concerned, a lot of people want. There's a lot of guys in there: Sean Porter, Keith Thurman, Errol Spence, and forget the other guy. But there's a lot of guys there. Who do you want to see Keith Thurman fight next? You don't want to see Danny Garcia fight next, and Sean Porter.
Honestly, I don't really give a damn who they fight.
Okay, not interested at all.
Not at all.
Okay, let me ask you this: out of all the welterweights, who is the number one welterweight right now?
Terence Crawford.
But a lot of people say he hasn't even fought at 147.
I don't give a damn, and he's the best.
You'll put him over Errol Spence and Keith Thurman?
He's the best, Terence Crawford.
Why do you speak so highly of him? I mean, I know why, but why do you have that?
The man got it all. He can do it all, man. He can box, he can punch, he can fight right-handed, left-handed, he can do it all.
So at this point, he hasn't been at 147, but do you think he cleans that division at this
Without
point?
Without a doubt.
Wow, okay. I'm surprised. And what do you think is going to be the outcome of him and Horn? You think that's a tough assignment? Is that a gauge?
It's a tough assignment because of where it's at. And on a guy like Horn is awkward. Very awkward and busy. So, you know, it's not going to be an easy task for him because of the style. You know, styles make fights. But I think once Terrence figures him out, it's a wrap.
Do you have any experience with Terrence? Have you been in the gym with him? Or is it just what you've seen in the...
Well, I see on TV, man. There's very few guys I watch on TV. There's very few I watch. I mean, Terrence Crawford's one, Errol Spencer's another. Anybody else? I'd rather go watch a repeat of King and Queens.
I like King and Queens, by the way.